Hi children, a very good morning to all. Welcome back to your English online classes. How was your exam? Okay, you have written very well. Very good. And we have discussed about the grammar session doing verbs in simple present tense. Doing verb means action words, verb that is simple present tense. What do you mean by simple present tense? Yes, tense is telling about a time. So simple present tense means it's a tense that describes about a habitual action, general too. Simple present tense is a tense. It describes about a habitual action or a general too. What do you mean by habitual action? Yes, the actions that we do in our day-to-day life that we can call habitual action. And what do you mean by general truth? An event that we never change that we can call general truth. For example, the sun rises in the east every morning. The sun rises in the east every morning. It's a general truth that we never change. The sun sets in the west every evening. The sun sets in the west every evening. It's also a general truth. Is it? It will change? No, it will never change. Such events we can call general truth. So simple present tense, it's talk about an habitual action or a general truth. So in the previous class, we have discussed about how to use the verb in simple present tense. If the noun is a singular noun, in such cases, we can add s with the verb. If the noun is a plural one, like I, you, we, they, like that, in such cases, we do not add s with the verb. We can use only the verb. So, with singular noun, we can use singular verbs. With plural noun, we can use the plural verbs. Now, we can see the examples to clear the topic.
What is a simple present tense and when do we use it? Simple present tense is a verb tense that we use to describe habitual actions and general truths. What are habits? The actions that we do in our day-to-day lives. For example, my brother drives his car every day. Here the verb is drives. See, look at the word every day. It shows it's a habitual action. My brother drives his car every day. Now we can see the examples for habitual actions. First one, they go to school by bus every day. They go to school by bus every day. It's a habitual action. Second one, she only eats fish. She only eats fish. Third one, I work in London. I work in London. So all these sentences, it shows it's a habitual action. Next one is general truths. An event that will never change. Such events we can call general truth. For example, first one, the sun rises from the east every morning. The sun rises from the east every morning. Another example, the sun sets in the west every evening. The sun sets in the west every evening. See, both these two sentences, it shows it's a general truth that will never change. Formula of the simple present tense. See, a sentence in simple present tense, we have a subject, a present verb and an object. Look at the given examples. First one, a child goes to school by van. A child goes to school by van. The second one, the children go to school by van. The children go to school by van. Children, now carefully observe the above two sentences. In the first sentence, we use the verb goes. But in the second sentence, we use the verb go. Do you know why we wrote like that? When we make that simple present tense, we use the plural verb with plural nouns and the singular verbs with singular nouns. When we make the simple present tense, we use the plural verb with plural nouns and the singular verbs with singular nouns. Look at the given table. Here they are given a table. In the first column they are written the verb form. In the second column they are written it singular forms. That means how to use it with he, she, it, like that, singular nouns. In the third column they are written it plural forms that we can use with you, we, they and I. The words are first one go, goes, go. Second word come, comes, come. Third one eat, eats, eat. Fourth one drink, drinks, drink. Fifth one write, writes, write. Sixth one sing, sings, sing. Seventh one dance, dances, dance. Eighth one sleep, sleeps, sleep. Ninth one walk, walks, walk. Tenth one talk, talks, talk. Next clean, cleans, clean. Listen, listens, listen. Look, looks, look. Catch, catches, catch. So children, in singular forms we can add s with the verb. In plural forms, we do not add s with the verb. Instead of adding s, we can write the verb only. Let us learn more about how to make the simple present tense. See, look at the given examples. First one, Ronnie listens to music every day. Ronnie listens to music every day. It's a habitual action. Here the noun is singular, Ronnie. So that's why we add s with the verb listen. So we got the verb listens. Ronnie listens to music every day. Second one, Sally visits her grandparents in the weekends. Sally visits her grandparents in the weekends. It's also a habitual action. The noun is singular, Sally. That's why we add s with the verb visit. So the sentence is like this. Sally visits her grandparents in the weekends. Third one, Ahas likes to eat noodles. Ahas likes to eat noodles. Here the noun is singular, Ahas, a boy. So that's why we add s with the verb. So we got the verb likes. Ahas likes to eat noodles. Next one, they watch a movie every Sunday. They watch a movie every Sunday. Here the noun is plural, they, more than one. That's why we do not add s with the verb. Instead of that, we can use only the verb. So we can write the sentence like this. They watch a movie every Sunday. Next one, the children like to eat noodles. The children like to eat noodles. Here the noun is plural, the children, more than one child. That's why we can write only the verb, that is like. Don't add s with the verb. So the sentence like this, the children like to eat noodles. Next example, I listen to the lessons very carefully. I listen to the lessons very carefully. Here the noun is I. I we can consider it as plural noun. That's why we do not add s with the verb. Instead of that, we can use only the verb listen. So the sentence like this, I listen to the lessons very carefully. And the next sentence, every day they go for a walk after dinner. Every day they go for a walk after dinner. Here the noun is plural, they, more than one person. So we can use the verb go. So the sentence, we can read it like this, every day they go for a walk after dinner.
So children, today we have discussed about simple present tense, how to use verbs in simple present tense. I hope you understood the topic. Then you should watch the YouTube URL that I attached with this classroom and do the worksheet and attend the test. And we can meet in the next classroom with the vocabulary session. So don't forget to read the textbook and do the worksheet. So we'll meet again. Thank you. Have a nice day.